Right, so here we are. We're going to make a small candle holder, which you can come up with various designs, and they'll fit a tea light. Obviously, that's an electronic tea light. Also fit a real tea light also. So what we're going to do is make up a plaster of Paris model, and we're going to use this cardboard tube, which is from a Pringle carton or chip crisp carton. You can use anything really, whatever suits your fancy. This is made from plaster of Paris, and this is going to be molded up with latex to make more of them, and I'll make those out of concrete. So we pour the plaster of Paris into this template here, or that makes our little template, and then we can sculpt the plaster of Paris to create our design. In this one, I'm going to make a kind of wood log looking thing like this one here, which this one's tapered. We'll get going and start on the first part. So the first part is to mix up our plaster of Paris. So as always, same quantity of water to the same quantity of plaster of Paris, and we'll mix the plaster of Paris in with the water, into the water, and mix that as we pour it in. So give that a stir, and stir it relatively slowly so you don't put any air bubbles into the plaster of Paris. I'll keep the air bubbles to a minimum. And once we've done that, we can pour that into our makeshift mould. Right, so here goes. And we'll let that stand for about an hour, and then we'll come back and demold the plaster of Paris shape. Right, so we've let this plaster of Paris set, and now we'll release the shape from the tube or carton. We'll do that carefully with a knife. Now we'll just turn that over so you've got the smooth side on the top, not that it matters too much, and we're going to drill a hole to fit in the tea light. Right, so we'll drill the hole. This is a 40mm drill bit, which is 1 inch and 9/16 of an inch. Just trying to find the center here. Actually, I'll mark that out with a screwdriver. Get the best we possibly can in the center. That looks good enough to me. So here goes, and obviously drill down to the depth of the tea light. It's a bit gooey, it's still a bit green. So we can wash that off with a bit of water. Got a bowl there. You don't want to be putting this in the sink, as it might clog your pipes up. Right, so we'll get on to the next stage, which is carving. So we'll let that go off a little bit more. It's still a bit wet, the plaster of Paris, but it will be pretty good for carving. So let it go off a little bit more, and then we'll come back. I'll clean it up a little bit, and go from there.
Right, okay, this has been let to dry off a little bit. And now we're going to sculpt in a kind of stump wood look. My hole's a little bit off-center, so if you make one of these, you'll probably do a better job than that. But anyway, we're going to carve in the stump. I have a bowl of water handy. I've got a bowl of water here. And that will wash off the excess plaster of Paris as we carve the sculpture. Right, so here goes. We'll put some lines. I think what we'll do is we'll start on the top, and we'll put some rings, which is going to simulate wood, with a bit of luck. So here goes.
Right, so I just scraped in the rings to give that woody effect, and I've just washed it off. I'm going to carve in the bark around the sides now, and we'll just make some lines and we'll refine them as we go through. This is the tool I'm using. I don't know what it's called. But you can use anything really, a nail, anything that's handy around the house or whatever. These have got sort of like a ball or sort of ball shaped thing on the end, and comes in quite handy. I'm going to use a paintbrush as well to smooth, soften up the lines as I go through. So I'll just continue. I'll like I say, put the bark effect around the side now. Okay, so that's where we're at. That's quite wet. I've obviously carved in, refined it a little bit, and washed it off with water, or washed the excess plaster with water. We'll let that go off for a bit. I might refine it a little bit more, and we'll put some paint on it, and see what it looks like. And once it's painted and dried, that'll be ready for moulding. Right, so we've let this fully dry. I let this dry for a few days. Now what we're going to do is just refine the edges a bit with a toothbrush. The plaster of Paris is, you can still work with it, and with brushes, just to maybe refine your edges and things. There we are, just whip round that with a toothbrush. I'm going to fill this hole in with a piece of clay, and then we're going to put an undercoat of paint on. Right, now we're going to put an undercut of paint on.
And bear in mind, this is just for just to see what the candle holder looks like, because this is going to be used as the model for a latex mold, and I'll show you what they will look like at the end of the video. So anyway, you can use these original models to practice paint jobs. I'm just going to put a coat of a dark colour just for the base, just to seal everything in, and I'm going to stipple that in with this paintbrush, because the plaster of Paris is very porous, and it's best to stipple it on when it's dry, because it would be hard to brush on. And we'll leave the undercoat to dry overnight, and then we can start adding some layers up.
Right, so here we are, we've got a few layers of the undercoat on, and now we're going to dry brush some browns and perhaps some yellows, kind of a yellow ochre. So get your dry, make sure your brushes are dry. And use a bit of black, brown paint, sorry. It was a bit gungy there. Right, so now I'm just going to dry brush this over the surface of the candle holder, and hopefully we get a kind of woody look. And I'm also going to apply some brown paint onto the top. I'm going to apply that thicker, put that into the simulated wood grain, because I'd like this to be a little bit lighter. Right, so we'll let that dry for a bit, and then we'll apply some more dry brush layers. Right, so I'm going to put a bit more brown around the candle holder. Those colours a bit stronger. Right, so there we are. So you put enough brown down, so it's more of a solid base of brown around the inner part of the stump. Just a dry brushed brown, leaving some of these darker areas on the base coat. So the dry brush brown is highlighting the simulation bark. So we'll let that dry, and we'll put some yellow ochre over the top and dry brush that on for some highlights. Right, now I'm going to apply some yellow ochre around the top. Also going to put some green and perhaps some yellow around the bark. So here goes the yellow ochre.
Right, so without that drying, I put a little bit of green in with the brown and the ochre dry brushed on the top of the bark part, and I've also just gone over a few times on the inner part of the stump with just yellow ochre. And I think I might build up a few more layers too, just to bring those colours out a little bit more. I might lighten up the ochre with a bit of white as well. So let that dry and come back and do a few more layers. Right, so now I'm just going to add a little bit of white to the yellow ochre and just dry brush a little bit of that over the top of that inner stump part. Also put some of this white mixed with the ochre around the tree stump, just subtly. So I've let this dry for a little bit longer. I'm just going to touch it up with a few highlights. I'm going to change the colour of the middle part of the stump. It looks a bit sterile as it is. And I'll perhaps put a little bit of red with brown and mix it with white. So here it goes.
Right, so I did actually dry brush a little bit of brown over the top of that white at the end, just to calm down those highlights on the bark. So you see I put a candle in there, and you can see the top now. So it turned out okay. Maybe a little bit rough, but or rustic as I prefer to say. So there's some more candle holders there, which perhaps have got more of a refined bark, as you can see there in the, if I can focus it in. And so it's up to you how far you want to go with these things. There's a couple more designs there, another one there. So there we are. So the plaster of Paris is actually quite hard to paint up, so once these are casted up in concrete, they'd be a lot easier to paint. And also I'll do the video on latexing these candle holders to make latex molds for concrete casts. I've already put a concrete cast video up of casting the candle holders, but I will do a latexing mold video. So anyway, there we are. Thank you very much, and over and out.